welcome to our 10-minute stretchy workout. Hopefully you've warmed up your shoulders and your neck a little bit and maybe a bit of thoracic spine before we get going. We're going to start off with chest and back lift. So crossing the arms over in front, looking up to the ceiling, hands behind the back. Bend the knees, arch the back all the way down. Rest your chest over your thighs, allow your head to relax, allow your arms to relax, and then lifting that belly button in as you roll up. Crossing over, hands behind the back, bend the knees. Make sure the knees are over the toes, all the way down. And then rounding the spine in the opposite direction to come back up. Two more, up to the top. Bend the knees straight away so you arch that spine. Last one, lifting up. One more, starting the same, and then stretching hamstrings while we get to the bottom. Allow the head to relax, the arms to relax. Four times, straightening your legs on the out breath, keeping the weight pitched forwards on the balls of the feet. And just softening the knees in between. Push the pubic bone forwards as you come up. Let's go into our dance stretches. Feet really nice and wide. Insteps parallel. Mirror me. So lifting the arm up, turn your shoulders to the corner. Flat back to the corner. Breath out in each position so that you deepen the stretch. Relax the upper body. Take hold of the ankle, head towards the knee. Bend the other knee. Feel the stretch transfer to your inside thigh. Lift the arm up to the ceiling. Rotate the shoulders. Keep the bent knee over your little toes. Relax in the middle and roll up. Other side. Arm up. Turn the shoulders only. Try and keep your hips square to the front. Lengthen towards the corner. Tuck your chin in. Nice deep breath out in each position. Hands to the ankle, head to the knee. Bending the other knee. Lifting the arm. Use the hand on the leg to pull the shoulders round. Relax in the middle. Rolling up. One more each time. Shoulders nice and relaxed, chin tucked in. So this is a stretch on your hamstrings. This is more of a stretch on the hamstrings. When you bend the knee, the stretch changes slightly. Inside thigh and across your side. Try and get a nice rotation here. Be relaxed in the head and neck. Rolling up through the centre. Last one. Arm up, turning. Using your breath to deepen every single stretch, every single time. A sense of lift up to the ceiling here. No tension in the upper body. Relax. And roll up. Great, let's turn the feet out to second position. So not just turn the feet out, turn the whole leg in the hip socket. And then we're coming into a plies in second. Knees over the toes. Just warming up gently to start with. Making sure those knees are really over your little toes and your upper body stays upright. No arching in the lower back. And then after a few, if you can, taking the arms up to the ceiling on an out breath as you deepen the bend each time. Let's have one more of those. Great, stay down there this time. Elbows on top, use your forearms. arms to push your knees back. This is a very strong stretch. Just try and relax and breathe. Try not to fight it. Good, and you might just want to just zhuzh a little bit from side to side. Hands to the floor. Turn your feet in, or turn your ankles out so that your feet are parallel. And then going through the middle with bent legs, straightening one leg. Keep your hands in the middle. Take your chest over with you towards the bent knee. A strong stretch all around the groin area. Breathing evenly as you go. Good, let's turn all the way around to the side. So come with me around to this side. Doesn't matter which leg you've got in front. And then making sure you've got a nice straight leg at the back and this knee is above or behind your ankle. Four times we're going to rock backwards and forwards. Bending the back knee and then bending the front knee. Same as before, breath in as you move into the position, breath out to hold it. Pull those toes up towards you of the front leg if you can. And if this all is a bit too much for your hamstring length, relax the back knee as you go back, but try and bring it up off the floor again when you come forward. So that was the four. Opposite hand next to the foot. Lift, arm up to the ceiling. Push back into that heel, nice straight leg at the back. And now drop that knee to the floor. Keep your hips really forwards. Keep the angle of this thigh the same. Both elbows towards the floor on the inside of that front leg. Breathing all the way through. Excellent. Let's change sides. Bring in the other leg forwards. Come to that really nice strong position. And back leg bends. Toes up on the front leg. Straight leg on the front leg as well. And then come forwards. Three more. Walking your forwards, your hands, sorry, backwards and forwards with you so that you're keeping your weight on your hands. Opposite hand next to foot, lifting up to the ceiling. Push back into that heel. Straight leg at the back if you can. Have a sense of lifting up out of the floor. And drop that back knee down, relax the foot. Elbows down towards the floor. Try and keep your shoulders even if you can. I'm coming back around to face the front. Coming into this on the walk position. And then bringing the front foot forwards in towards your groin, taking the weight onto the hands and sliding the other leg out behind you. So you should already be feeling quite a nice stretch on the outside hip, thigh and hip. And then elbows down towards the floor. If you're not really feeling this, bring the front leg more forwards. And stretching the arms away. Lifting the chest up only, keep the legs where they are. Opposite hand to foot, behind you. Really slide that back leg away, that back knee away. And if you can, rotate the shoulders round as well. Breathing all the way through. I'm just going to do that on the other leg facing the side so you can get a slightly different angle. So from here, bringing the front foot closer to your groin, sliding the back leg away directly behind your hips. And then down onto your elbows and slide the arms away. chest. So the legs stay where they are, bringing that opposite hand to foot and rotating the shoulders round if you can. The important part here is the position of that back knee. Make sure you're not on your kneecap, you're on the end of your thigh. Well done. A couple more stretches to go. On all fours. Let's take the big toes together, knees nice and wide, stretch your hips all the way back on your heels, stretch your arms away. First of all, press your chest into the floor. Then you're going to thread the needle, take one hand through, stretch it as far away as it'll go, turn your head to follow it, relax your head, stretch both hands away, another half an inch. Stay there and breathe. Should feel a nice stretch between your shoulder blades. Especially on the in-breath. And let's change sides. Slide through, relax the head and neck. Fantastic. Coming up onto all fours, but a square up all fours now. So toes apart, hip width apart. Place your left hand in front of your right fingertips and sit your heels back on your hips. You should feel a nice strong stretch on your left side, sort of down the seam of your top. Breathe. Coming back to all fours, change sides. So the heel of your palm touching your fingertips. And then take the hips back. You might not get your hips anywhere near your heels, don't worry. And up onto all fours. Curl your toes under, lift your hips, push your chest back through your arms, and then just bring your feet a little bit closer together, staying in that downward dog position, bending one knee, pushing the other heel down towards the floor, strongly stretching the calf of that straight leg. About six of these, gently padding through, and then hold one side. Breathe deeply. Change sides. Last one. Both legs straight, but then bend your knees. Arch that lower back so you send your sit bones high up to the ceiling and then straighten the legs. It's a very strong stretch, all at the backs of your legs. Hold it there if you can, breathe. And walk the hands back to the feet, keeping the legs straight. Just slightly soften the knees, draw the belly button in, leave the arms to hang, leave the head to hang, push the pubic bone forwards as you roll up through the spine, all the way to the top. And then just a lovely shoulder roll and a settling of the hair, and we're done. That's our stretchy workout. Thank you.